Shalom, and welcome to the Pirke of the Week. We are moving through Chapter 3 of Pirke Avot with the third teaching, in which Rabbi Chananya, the son of Teradyon, said, "If two sit together and there are no words of Torah between them, then behold, this is a gathering of jokers. As it is said, do not sit in a gathering of jesters," quoting the Book of Psalms. But two who sit together and there are words of Torah between them, the Shechinah, that is, God's holy presence, is with them, as it is said. Thus spoke those who are in awe of God, a person to their friend, and God was attentive and heard, and a book of memory was recorded for those who are in awe of God to remember their name. That is quoting the prophet Malachi. Not only two, Rabbi Chananya continues, even if one sits and studies Torah, does the Holy Blessed One not bestow a reward on them? As it is said, one who sits alone in silence, he takes it upon himself. A third quote from the Book of Lamentations this time. Three proof texts are brought, and this makes it a little challenging to unpack the fundamental teaching. It is a classic rabbinic practice to find biblical sources which might shed light on or support a particular teaching or answer a question. So don't be deterred by the repetition of as it is said, and the sometimes inaccessible verses that are inserted into these thoughts. One further issue of translation: how do we translate this word late seem, jesters or jokers, also translated mockers, scorners? It's obviously presented here as a negative, yet in other instances, it is a positive attribute to make others laugh. A sense of humor is surely important. And the Talmud depicts two jesters as having immediate entree into the world to come. Lifting the spirits of others is such a mitzvah. So as in every trait, it is all about finding the appropriate balance and time to express any particular quality. Yet Rabbi Chananya clearly wants us to uplift our everyday activities by inserting uplifting conversation into our lives. If we're sitting together with a friend, he suggests that we elevate the conversation and share something substantive, that we take every opportunity to increase our wisdom and to learn something. The Shechinah, God's presence, is understood by the tradition to be the feminine aspect of God, God closest to us, God as immanent. And when we have moments alone, we are also advised to use this time wisely. And what a charming image of God listening into the conversation and taking notes in the book of our lives. This text invites us to consider how can we elevate our routine conversation and how can we best use the moments we have to ourselves. Let's make choices that would make God smile, as it were. Shavua Tov and Chag Sameach.